This video explains some of the main concepts behind implementing SharePoint federated search between SharePoint Online and an on-premises deployment of SharePoint Server 2013. With SharePoint federated search, we can enable one search from either deployment to return search results that include content from both deployments. We call this capability hybrid SharePoint search. So let's say that we have an environment that includes both SharePoint Online and an on-premises deployment of SharePoint Server 2013, and there's different content in each deployment. And let's say that for now, the two deployments aren't connected in any way. None of their services and features, such as SharePoint search capabilities, are integrated. However, SharePoint search is configured and available in each deployment separately, so that users of either deployment can get search results locally. SharePoint Online users can get search results only from content in SharePoint Online, and SharePoint Server 2013 users can get search results only from the content in that deployment. There are several search-related challenges for users in an environment like this. Users might need to be able to search for content in both deployments. Users have to go to each deployment separately to search for content there. Users might not know which deployment to search in to find the content they need. And users might not have credentials to work in both deployments, or they might have to have separate credentials for each deployment. Clearly, this isn't a friendly environment for users to readily find all of the content that they might be looking for. So, how can we enable users of either deployment to do a single search that returns search results that include content from both deployments? In other words, how can we implement the following hybrid SharePoint search solutions? In hybrid SharePoint search solution 1, users working in the SharePoint Server 2013 deployment can get search results from content in both deployments and view them on a search results page in SharePoint Server 2013. However, users working in SharePoint Online can still only get search results from content in SharePoint Online. In hybrid SharePoint search solution 2, users working in SharePoint Online can get search results from content in both deployments and view them on a search results page in SharePoint Online. However, users working in the SharePoint Server 2013 deployment can still only get search results from content in SharePoint Server 2013. For hybrid SharePoint search solution 3, we implement both solution 1 and solution 2 so that users working in either deployment can get search results from content in both deployments. To enable search solution 1, why not use the search service in the SharePoint Server 2013 deployment to crawl the content in both deployments? If we could do that, all of the crawled content would go into a search index in the SharePoint Server 2013 deployment that users could query from the search center there. Well, this isn't possible without a custom solution. Although an on-premises SharePoint Server 2013 deployment can crawl content in another on-premises SharePoint 2013 deployment, it can't crawl content in SharePoint Online. Similarly, to enable search solution 2, why not have the search service in SharePoint Online crawl the content in both deployments? If we could do that, all of the crawled content would go into a search index in SharePoint Online that users could query from the SharePoint Online Search Center. However, this isn't possible either, because SharePoint Online can only crawl content in SharePoint Online. So instead, our approach will be to configure the two deployments as a hybrid SharePoint environment. This will enable solutions that integrate functionality between services and features of SharePoint Online and the SharePoint Server 2013 deployment. For example, we'll then be able to enable users in each deployment to get federated search results. That is, users of either deployment will be able to get search results from the local search index and the remote search index at the same time. Setting up the base configuration for the hybrid SharePoint environment will be accomplished in two phases, each of which must be implemented in order for us to be able to move on to phase 3. Phase 1 will establish the hybrid environment infrastructure, and phase 2 will establish the hybrid identity management infrastructure. After completion of those two phases, in phase 3, we can implement one or more optional hybrid SharePoint solutions, including SharePoint Federated Search, Microsoft Business Connectivity Services, and Duet Enterprise Online for Microsoft SharePoint and SAP. Each of these optional solutions integrates certain functionality between SharePoint Server 2013 and SharePoint Online. Phases 1 and 2 will include tasks to integrate the two deployments, such as setting up directory synchronization, or DirSync, to synchronize user accounts from the on-premises directory service to Windows Azure Active Directory, and setting up server-to-server trust so that each deployment can access and share resources from the other deployment. Now, it's beyond the scope of this video to discuss phases 1 and 2 any further. For details about all phases of the hybrid configuration process, you can consult the hybrid SharePoint resources on Microsoft TechNet at the URL shown at the bottom right of this slide. We'll show this URL again at the end of the video. Let's assume now that phases 1 and 2 are complete and look briefly at how to enable hybrid SharePoint search in phase 3 and how search will work for users after that. To implement hybrid search solutions, there are two main search configuration steps. 1. Create a result source, and 2. Create an associated query rule. We perform these two steps in the deployment we want to get hybrid search results in. So we can perform the two steps in SharePoint Online, or in SharePoint Server 2013, or in both. First, we create a result source that specifies the remote SharePoint location to get search results from. For example, to get hybrid search results in SharePoint Server 2013, we would create a result source in SharePoint Server 2013 that specifies the root site collection in SharePoint Online as the location to get search results from. Second, we create a query rule that fires for any query text, gets search results from the result source that we just created, and causes those results to be displayed in the local deployment along with results from the local search index. Those two main steps take care of the necessary search-related configuration. Now let's take a look at a high level at how each hybrid SharePoint search solution will work. In hybrid SharePoint search solution 1, when a user types a query in a search box in the SharePoint Server 2013 deployment, the query is sent to the local search index and to the remote SharePoint Online search index, and the search returns results from both indexes so that the user can view the results in the SharePoint Server 2013 deployment. And we can choose to show the results that are from the remote index in a single block at the top of the search results page, and show local results below that. In hybrid SharePoint search solution 2, when a user types a query in a search box in SharePoint Online, the query is sent to the local search index, and it is also sent through a reverse proxy to the remote SharePoint Server 2013 search index. The search then returns results from both indexes so that the user can view the results in SharePoint Online. And, as in search solution 1, we can choose to show the results that are from the remote index in a single block at the top of the search results page and show local results below that. For hybrid SharePoint search solution 3, we implement both solution 1 and solution 2, so that users working in either deployment can get search results from the search indexes of both deployments. Since the two search solutions require the same base configuration other than the reverse proxy, and are otherwise independent of one another, an organization can provide either solution first, and optionally then also provide the other solution. So this has been a quick look at some of the main concepts behind implementing hybrid SharePoint search. For more information, see the hybrid SharePoint resources on Microsoft TechNet. Thanks for watching.